Hi folks, and welcome to ATLab. This is a mega DIY portable power station that I built at low cost, mainly using recycled materials, and in this video I will explain how. For a big project like this, you need a battery, and actually why not two? I chose two 12V 100Ah lithium iron phosphate batteries for a total of 2.4 kWh. This type of battery has the unique feature of supporting deep discharge with over 4000 cycles, even at 100% discharge. They are the most expensive components of the entire project. The first thing to do is check the voltage of the batteries upon arrival. Mine read 12.7 volts for both, which is great. The second step is deciding how to connect them, in parallel or in series. Connecting the batteries in parallel means working with 12 volt and managing over 200 amp, which is really a lot and risks current imbalances. It is doable but requires a 12 volt inverter. Connecting the batteries in series doubles the voltage to 24 volt while halving the current. Still, 100 amp is significant, but more manageable, and you'll need a 24 volts to 230 volts inverter. Finally, if you plan to use just a single battery, you'll also need a 12 volts to 230 volts inverter. In addition to the batteries, you'll need a lot of stuff like cables, outlets, meters, current monitors, and a pure sine wave inverter. And of course, you'll need a case to house everything. I used an old server case that I repurposed. My god, this thing is crazy heavy. It weighs more than the batteries. I must throw away lots of stuff here.
E anche con questo se ne va via un altro bel chiletto. E via un altro, e siamo meno due.
After removing all the unnecessary parts, I managed to lighten the case by a whole 14 kilos. The ancient built stuff properly, they used to weigh a ton. I positioned the first battery and prepared the cables for the connection. You need cable with the necessary cross-section suitable for 100 amp currents. I recommend at least 25 square millimeters, and for a proper job, terminate them with ring terminals, which I crimp and also solder with thin for a secure hold. I added the power switch, in my case a recycled multiple disconnector switch rated for 63 amp. By wiring all the contacts in parallel, the current capacity increases, making it capable of handling 100 amp. I suggest you to get a switch with an adequate rating. I'll include product links here in the description. I prepared the cables precisely to distribute the currents evenly across the contacts. Then mounted the switch on the front panel of the server case using a steel bracket made from scrap. I moved forward attaching the positive terminal and the negative terminal huge cables. And why not using my 3D printer? I created parts to secure the second battery, which I placed on top of the first. To handle the batteries safely, I strongly recommend you insulating the terminals to prevent accidents. Believe me, I learned this the hard way. Sparks flew and a bolt even melted. After securing everything with the last 3D printed parts, I connected the negative terminal of the lower battery to the positive terminal of the upper one to link them in series. For the final connection, I used a massive copper bar, cutting and drilling it to fit. It's a lot of work for a single component, but it ensures a stable connection to the shunt that measures the current flowing to various loads. Here goes 100 amp. I also insulated the shunt for safety. Then I realized that the hole I made for the shunt to pass through the case was too small. What the hell? So I need to enlarge it manually. And finally, I managed to fit everything in place. The inverter required a small modification. I replaced the screw terminals with a bare ring terminal for direct connection to the bus bar. Before installing the inverter, in the case, I connected the shunt to the copper bar and the negative of the battery and drew the positive cable from the switch. And here it is, all set up, a true masterpiece of engineering. You can see the copper bar underneath, the shunt running through the frame, which I slightly insulated. I'll probably 3D printed something to secure it better. The current then goes straight to the inverter, and now it's time to turn everything on. And let's hope nothing blows up.
Yeah, good.
And you heard that? The switch loudly engaged. Somewhere down here, there should be the power button, and there it is. It beeped. That means that the inverter turned on, and now I just need to route the outlet socket to the front panel. The inverter is a 12 volts to 230 volts pure sine wave model, rated for 3 kilowatt peak and 1.5 kilowatt continuous power. Inside it has a high-frequency transformer that steps up the voltage to over 350 volts DC, followed by a full bridge inverter that converts the DC into pure sine AC, passing through a filter with an inductor and a capacitor to smooth the high frequency. I modified it as I want the control switch and the output socket on the front panel of the case. So I solder extension wires directly to the circuit boards. Two wires for the switch and two wires for the 230 volt AC. I installed a 230 volts socket and an energy meter on a DIN rail. With the help of 3D printed parts, I also secured the inverter on switch. I have included the full wiring diagram at the end of the video, and I mounted everything in the case below the main switch. But that's not all. I printed black ABS panels for additional modular features. On one panel, I installed low voltage convenience like a USB outlet and a small adjustable power supply, 0 to 24 volt, 20 amp. I also added a display to monitor the output voltage and a terminal for easy connection like a power supply. The adjustable power supply is a buck converter that I modified by replacing the CV trimmer with a 100k potentiometer, allowing me to extend the wires and mount it on the front panel. I also added a fast charging USB port quick charge and soldered the power leads to the module switch. I tested everything with a bench power supply to ensure it worked before final assembly. This custom feature is something that you cannot find on commercial power station. On the second panel, I mounted an XT90 connector directly linked to the batteries, allowing for high current output when needed. I also installed a display to monitor the current and voltage of the loads. Once everything was mounted on the server case, I finalized the wiring using properly crimped terminals to prevent disconnection. And everything is finally wired, and now I'm really, really nervous after the initial flame, but super curious to see if all works. I turn the knob and voila, the output indicator shows the voltage and the current, which is not that accurate. Don't ask me why, but there seems to be 230 milliamp flowing for nothing. Maybe it is just a missed calibration. Here it is, the XT90 connector straight to the battery, and here the masterpiece with the voltage regulator that works perfectly. But the current when it's on decreases and it goes up when it's off. Strange things here, I think. Here it is, the inverter, which, yes, it beeps and it should turn on. And yeah, it's super nice, the display shows the voltage, the frequency and the correct current readings. And it's finally time, I close the case with its panel and I declare this part of the project complete. You will see this power station in action in future videos. And next steps will be managing the battery and charging, like using solar panel and an MPPT charge controller. If you are curious about the wiring diagram, it's included here and will be also published on my social pages. I'm super grateful for your attention. Please consider leaving a like and a comment here below and subscribe to the ATLab channel if you haven't already. And please check out my social media pages on Patreon, Telegram, Instagram and Facebook to stay updated on the activities happening in my little lab and to support my work. And see you in the next video. Bye bye!